Hi, Lily Lakers. Welcome to our last week of home yoga. Hopefully next fall, we'll all be back in the media center and enjoying our time together. Today, we are gonna talk a little bit about families, all different kinds of families, because we have been spending so much time with our families these days, and that time together hopefully has been a blessing. We've gotten to know each other better over this time and really come to depend and lean on our families during this time. Today we're going to be reading this book by Karamo Brown called I Am Perfectly Designed. Now the family that's written about in this book is a little boy and his dad. That's what his family looks like. Now on the entry, the first page, I guess, of this book, you can see there's all different kinds of families are highlighted on here. So while you're doing your yoga today, maybe you could think about what your family looks like, who makes up your family. Not only the people that live in your household, maybe, but your extended family, things like that. Who is special to you? Okay? So as we do our breath ball breaths today, why don't you bring someone special from your family into your mind? I have someone from my special family right behind the camera, my daughter Ellie. So that's the easy one for me today. Let's see, let's do, I think, 5 breaths today, okay? Sit up nice and tall, friends. Okay. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, we're on 3. And exhale. Inhale. 4. And exhale. And our last. And exhale. Good. Now, friends, we're going to do some yoga poses today. Most of these poses we've done a lot of times, okay? So let's go ahead. Today, we are going to start in child's pose. So come back into your child's pose, sitting on your feet, knees down, elbows down, and rest your head. Good. Keeping your head rested, breathe in and out 3 times. You can feel your belly rise and fall like the ocean on your legs, that tide coming in and out. Once again, bring into your mind someone who is special to you and your family. Okay, plant your hands. We're gonna tip our toes and come up into our first downward dog. You can pedal out 1 foot and then the other. If your legs feel tight, and then find some stillness. Good. Come forward into your high plank. Good. Lower down. Push up. Oh, my back cracked. Good. Push back once again into your child's pose. Feeling those deep belly breaths once more. Let's come back into tabletop for a moment. Tip your toes and up into downward dog. big breath here. And on your exhale, come forward into your high plank. Lower down. Push up into cobra. And back once more into your child's pose. Okay, friends. From here, let's just sit back on our heels and come to standing. Okay? We're all good, Ellie? Okay. Hands together at heart center. We're going to step our right foot back into warrior one. Raise your hands to the sky. Very good. Bring your hands back. We'll go up into airplane. Remember to look at something that's not moving. Very good. Back into warrior one. Very good. And back to mountain. Okay, great friends. Now we'll do that on the other side. Step your left foot back, or the opposite of the foot that you used before. Raise your hands to the sky for your warrior one. Bring your arms back. Shift forward to your front foot for airplane. Bring your back foot off the ground. And back down for warrior one. Very good, friends. Step your feet together for mountain. Now, friends, we're going to do our balancing poses, okay? We're going to add one more balancing pose in today called eagle. Ellie, would you like to help with this today?
Sure.
Okay. We're gonna have Ellie come up and help us.
I need you to hold the
camera.
We're
gonna switch places. Okay, Ellie. There she is. Okay, Ellie, can you go into chair pose? Very good. Now, cross your right leg over your left. Very good. And then your right arm under your left arm. Oh, gorgeous. Beautiful, Ellie. And that's okay. It's so easy to fall out of this pose. And see how Ellie just put her foot down? You can kickstand, and that helps you keep your balance a little better. Now from here, Ellie, could you unwind and go right into tree? It's no problem if you have to put your foot down between. Yep, and you can kickstand your foot like Ellie's doing right there. And then when you're ready, you can put your hands up high to the sky. Good. Good job, Ellie. All right, should we try the other side? Okay, you wanna step your feet out a little bit? There you go. Okay, come back into chair. There you go. This time, Ellie's going to put her left leg over her right. You can do it the opposite of whichever leg you used before. Cross your left elbow under your right. There you go. Yes, very good. Yep, you can keep it up. You can kickstand it on the mat. There you go. Very good. Your muscles get tight, don't they? They're tired. Okay, unwind and see. Yep, she put her foot down, no problem. Just get into tree as quick as you can. You can keep your foot up like Ellie is or kickstand it on the mat. Yep, and then you can raise your hands to the sky when you're ready. Excellent. Okay, good job, sweetie. You can plant them back down. All right, Ellie and I are gonna trade spots. Okay. Very good. You can come to seated now on your mat. We'll just do a couple of stretches. We'll do river pose, leaning forward. Try to remember like a string that's coming from the top of your head. So you might not lean that far forward, but it's a nice stretch for your back and your legs. Okay, I'm touching my legs. You can also reach for your ankles or your toes. Good. Okay, Now I'm going to turn sideways and lay down on the floor. And we can put our legs at the wall like this. Mm-hmm. Just relax and see if you can feel your feet. They start to feel lighter as they're raised to the sky. See if you can feel that. Good job. Bring your feet back to your mat. We're gonna do our twist. So let your knees drop to the left and your gaze go to the right. So your nose is going to point towards the right and your arms will be out to the sides. Plant your feet, knees up, and then let your knees fall to the other side and your gaze goes towards the left. You just always want your nose and your knees to be opposite of one another. Okay, good job, friends. Now plant your feet. We're going to take our arms around our thighs or the back of your legs and rock and roll up to seated. Good. Now we have the last part of our class today, which is our book part. And again, this book highlights the specialness of being in a family. And that each one of you in a family is specially made, uniquely made, and is perfect, just as you are. I'm going to turn my music down here. Now this book has the dad talking and then the son talking. They're talking back and forth to each other, okay? So I'll try to point to the person who's talking. Okay. He says, first there was you, Dad, and then there was me. And now there is us. That's right. Now there is us. When you first saw me, you said, he is perfectly designed from his head to his toes. And I meant every word of it. How many of you like to eat pancakes in the morning? Special treat. When I was a baby, I looked just like you, only I had no hair and you had lots. Now it's the opposite. So true, says the dad. Remember that? I had such a big baby head. Indeed, but your big baby head was perfectly designed for you. The first thing I remember is being carried on your shoulders when you walked me all over the city. How many of you got carried around in a pack like that? I know my kids got carried around quite a bit in a little pack like that. When I was real little, I thought you could touch the moon, Dad. Remember that? We'd sit on the roof and reach for it. One day, you'll be big enough to reach it yourself. But until then, it's perfectly okay to ask for help. Remember when we went as syrup and waffles for Halloween, Dad? Ha ha, I do. That was awesome. I wonder what will be this year. Have you ever had a partner costume with someone for Halloween? It's kind of fun, huh? When I run in the park, jump in the park, climb in the trees in the park. And I pretend I am a statue in the park. You remind me I am perfectly designed to explore the world. You are, and you always will be. What do you think they're looking up at? You can kind of see some shadows, maybe from a tree above them on their picnic. Like he's looking at his dad. Sometimes, Dad, when I get mad or sad or confused, you wrap me in your arms, and I like that. Me too. And I remind you that you are perfectly designed and wonderful, no matter what you're feeling. We've had a lot of big feelings at home in these weeks, haven't we? And that's okay. It's good to have those feelings. Dad, when I grow up and leave home, will you miss me? Yes, very much. Will you go into my room and play with my race cars and stuffed animals? You know I will. Will you sit on the fire escape and feed the pigeons like we do in the summer? The pigeons and the sparrows. Will you remember my favorite moves? I will, and I'll invent some new ones. They like to have dance parties, huh? Dad, will you always think of me? Always. You know what, Dad?
What?
I will always remember walking through the city and sitting on your shoulders. And maybe when you're older and I'm taller, I can carry you on mine, because we are perfectly designed for each other. That's right. Now, actually, Ellie, can you zoom in on this picture? This is a boy that wrote the book for when he was younger, and this is his dad. Okay. Now, friends, something interesting I noticed about this book. On the cover, you can see the little boy and his dad sitting on this bench. But on the inside, on the hard part of the cover, this bench is empty. So if you think about it and you like to draw, maybe you could draw a bench like this and imagine who you would put on your bench from your family. Okay? So that's something you could do later on, maybe when you're resting or watching a show or something. But for now, we're going to close with our volcano breath. And first, actually, I just want to thank you for watching these and spending this time in quarantine. Practicing yoga with me. Really appreciated my time with you. Okay? All right, hands to heart. Let's bring someone from our family that loves us to our mind. And breathe them in. And send them your wish. Good job, friends. I'll see you next year.